Making music is all about making decisions. And if you're having trouble finishing songs, it might be because you're not committing to your music. You might be leaving too many options open, and therefore you can always go back and fix things and not moving forward. And this leads you to question your decisions, and those questions cause self-doubt. I've got this project open, made with my accordion and beyond Ableton Live Pack. Every single sound is made with an accordion. And it's all MIDI, and some of the tracks have effects on it. Now, many DAWs have a feature called Bounce in Place that allows you to take your tracks and render them into audio, so all the effects are printed. Ableton Live does not have that, but I want to show you how you can get the same exact effect in here. So I want to take this percussion track and turn it into audio. I want to bounce it into place so that this MIDI becomes audio and the effect on here is processed. So the first thing I'm going to do just to be safe is I'm going to drag this track into my browser in my current projects folder, and Live will create a new Live set with just that track. I'll get back to why I did that later. It's not a necessary step, but it'll help you out in the long run. I'm going to right click on this clip right here, and I'm going to select Freeze Track. And Live will freeze the track, so it turns it into audio. What it's really doing is going into our samples folder and creating a freeze file right here. And that's what we're really hearing when I play back this track. So I'm going to just solo this so you can hear it. And we're hearing the freeze track. If I create a new audio track, I can option drag this directly on the audio track, and we've got our freezed file here. And now I could just delete this track. Alternatively, I could right-click this and select Flatten. And now Live has removed all the plugins and the instruments and made an audio track. And now I can treat this like audio. I can do things like pitch it down. I could reverse it. And that's essentially how we bounce in place in Ableton Live. So now we've made a decision. We've committed our track. Now, as much as I love committing, sometimes you do want a way out. Now, this is why I've dragged my track into the browser, because now if I don't like what I did here, I can just drag this right back in here. And I've got what I started with. I can delete the frozen file or the bounced in place, and now I'm back to where I started. So it's a little bit of a safety measure. One of the most important things you can do when making music is make decisions and commit to them. I've got an episode of the Music Production Podcast where I talk about this in depth and how this mindset of moving forward, committing, and keep going will make you more creative and ultimately help you finish more music. You can check it out in the link above. Thanks so much for watching, and keep at it, because a little bit every day goes a long way. Have a great day.